What's going on, guys? This is Ryan with RK Outpost, and coming off May 25th, real Star Wars Day, you had a lot of people talking about Star Wars, whether that be because Star Wars, then renamed into A New Hope, was released in 1977, because Return of the Jedi was released in 1983, or even because you had people saying hashtag make Solo 2 happen. A lot of people were talking Star Wars, but now we know that the next upcoming big event in Star Wars is not going to be happening for a long time. It has been delayed. You can see right here, Star Wars official Twitter account. Star Wars The High Republic sees revised release dates. Get the full details on StarWars.com. Now, there might be some people who don't know what Star Wars The High Republic is. We covered it here on this channel. There is this big secret project, Project Luminous, involving many different authors, both comic books and novels. And they all got together, wrote this interconnected story that we were supposed to see starting in August, set 200 years before the prequel trilogy. That has now been delayed. Another hiccup for Star Wars, another hiccup for Lucasfilm. But let's go ahead and check it out. I just saw this first comment. Oh man, what is this? Another brutal Disney show? That's pretty funny. Didn't see that originally. All right, StarWars.com. Star Wars The High Republic. Star Wars The High Republic sees revised release dates. The highly anticipated publishing initiative will kick off in January 2021, following recent world events. Now, this announcement by itself isn't necessarily a surprise, but one thing to consider is that this was supposed to launch alongside Star Wars Celebration at Star Wars Celebration. We haven't got any official word yet about Celebration, although most people assume that it will be canceled because it is going to be in Anaheim. As someone who lives in Southern California, I can tell you how insane they are right here and how highly unlikely I think it's going to be that they allow Celebration to happen. But that's a story for a different time. Both Charles Soule are here. Lucasfilm has confirmed new dates for the launch of Star Wars The High Republic due to general marketplace delays. Now, again, we know of all the delays that are going right now in comics between Diamond, you know, shutting down for a while, between Marvel and DC, just putting things out digitally. Things like that have been going down. So there are comic books associated with The High Republic. I haven't really heard too much about books and things like that being delayed, maybe because I haven't been paying so much attention to it. But I would imagine that a lot of the same problems that they would be having with distributing books and things like, or with comics and things like that, may be flooding into books as well. I'm not sure. Both Charles Soule's adult novel, Star Wars The High Republic, Light of the Jedi, that's the first one that we were supposed to see, and Justina Ireland's middle grade novel, Star Wars The High Republic, A Test of Courage, will both now release on January 5th, 2021. Claudia Gray's young adult novel, Star Wars The High Republic Into the Dark, has moved to a new release date of February 2nd, 2021. Now that is interesting. Originally, it was just supposed to be Light of the Jedi coming out the same weekend that Star Wars Celebration happened, late August. But now the fact they're moving that up and releasing Justina Ireland's book at the same time is interesting. Now, I've done a video talking about some of the authors of The High Republic, specifically Justina Ireland and Claudia Gray, and why I feel like they are not a good fit and why I feel like identity politics will be a problem. If you remember, we had the infamous whiteboard that had diversity and representation as something that was they really wanted to make a big part of Star Wars The High Republic, and I don't put it past Claudia Gray, Justina Ireland, and Daniel Jose Older to make sure that they put that foremost as opposed to worrying about the actual story. New release dates for Marvel's Star Wars The High Republic series and IDW Publishing Star Wars The High Republic Adventures will be announced at a later time, so we don't even know what those are going to be moved back to. Star Wars The High Republic is set in an era when Galactic Republic and the Jedi Order are at their zenith, roughly 200 years before the events of Star Wars The Phantom Menace. So just like I talked about, and you know, we saw the characters and we laughed a little bit about the characters in The High Republic. You obviously, you know, have Avar Chris, who of course is, you know, the white female main character protagonist. We don't have a lot of those in Star Wars, especially Disney Star Wars. So, you know, great job. We've seen this absolute trash artwork. We've seen some redos by people like Stephen Wayne that are pretty interesting, but this doesn't appeal to a lot of people, especially when you read her background and you realize that she's essentially the best of the best of the best of the best. Bottom line, she has no weaknesses. She's just a badass. Of course, something that we are all really looking forward to. And you have a couple other characters. You have Loden Greatstorm. You have, ooh, everyone's favorite. You know that haircut when you see that haircut. I think if you follow Jeremy's Twitter account, he may have said something about haircuts like this before. Keeve Trennis. To be quite honest, I felt like she had the most interesting backstory of all of them. At least she seems like she had some sort of weakness. You know, she has a crisis of confidence. And I can at least, like, relate a little bit with that and understand that. So we'll see how she ends up. You, of course, have Stellan Geos, who is only a badass when he's with Eivor, only when he's a part of the team. Other than that, he's just a little bitch. And then, of course, the young prodigy, who is better than anyone ever at her age, Vern, Venestra Vern Rowe, however you say her name. This is the one that I believe Justina Ireland will be writing her young adult novel focused on. So that's a little bit about these characters if you weren't quite familiar with them before. But at the end of the day, it is going to be delayed. Does that officially mean that Celebration is delayed as well? Is Celebration dead? Are they just going to cancel it? Are they going to reschedule it maybe to early January to match up with that? I don't know. We can see. Let's confirm those release dates again. January 5th. 2021, so right after New Year's. It's been a lot of question. Will they cancel Celebration? Will they move Celebration? I don't know. I do have tickets to Celebration. It's going to be really interesting how that all plays out, but only time will tell. It's all speculation at this point. As far as the High Republic, I've said many times that this could be a great opportunity for Disney Lucasfilm Publishing to show us that they can tell an interconnected story. They can create their own stories in an interconnected way and show that they can do continuity the right way. Like was done so long with the Star Wars Expanded Universe that you decided to throw away. I'm sure you're going to pick and borrow and beg and steal different things from these great stories from the Star Wars EU that you threw away for your High Republic. But I don't have any faith that it will be good. I just don't. I think that Kevin Scott and Charles Soule, right? They're both good authors. We'll see how it goes. The other ones, like I said, I will link in the card here to a video that I made about these people and why I don't think you should trust them with Star Wars or really anything that anyone reads at any time, to be quite honest. But let me know what you think about this announcement, about the delay. What does it mean for Star Wars Celebration? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure you smash a like button, subscribe to the channel, ring the bell for notifications, share this video out there, and I will talk to you later. Thanks for watching, everyone. And a huge shout out to my patrons. I appreciate you guys so much. Want to follow me on Twitter or Instagram? Check out the description below. You'll find links to my PO box and my Patreon as well. And I'll talk to you guys later.